In our today's class, I'll explain about experimental procedure for the determination of relative lowering of vapor pressure. So you can see this method is called as Ostwald's-Walker's method. You can see the Ostwald's-Walker's apparatus, which consists of three bulbs. First three bulbs consist of varied amount of solution. This solution consists of non-volatile solute. Remember, non-volatile solute means it is non-evaporative in nature. Next three bulbs consist of solvent, only pure solvent. That means you can see, you can say this as a water. And next three U tubes consist of calcium chloride, dry calcium chloride. That means it is also weighed. It is weighed and weight is calculated. In three cases, weight is calculated. Okay, so now what we will do, from this side, we are bubbling dry air. When we are bubbling dry air, it takes some vapors of the solvent. Because solute is already non-volatile in nature, so dry air is coming from this direction and passing through all tubes. So when we are passing dry air, it is saturated with the vapors of the solvent present in these first three tubes. So when it is going from this side to this side, it is taking the vapors from this direction to this direction. So already vapors are there. There is a development of the vapor pressure. There is some loss in the weight because it is taking the vapors from solution bulbs to the solvent bulbs. So loss in weight of solution is proportional to the vapor pressure of the solvent, or vapor pressure of the solution, because it is taking only vapors of the solvent from this direction to this direction. Okay, so next, coming to next three bulbs consists of only solvent, only pure solvent. So you can consider it as a water. So when this dry air is coming, when it is not dry air now, it is wet air, because it is already bringing these three tubes vapors from this direction to this direction. So it is already filled with some vapors of the solution. And when air is passing, it also takes the vapors of the solvent. So now there is a loss in the solvent tubes. Loss in weight of solvent is proportional to the P0 minus PS, original solvent vapor pressure and solution vapor pressure. So we are mentioning the difference. So now what I will do, I'll add both loss in weight of solvent plus loss in weight of solution. It is proportional to P0 minus PS plus PS. So PS, PS in both cases it is cancelled and we will get only P0. So when we cancel PS, we'll get only P0. That means loss in weight in both the cases of solvent or solution is directly proportional to the vapor pressure of solvent. So in both the cases, only solvent is losing. So vapor pressure of solvent. Okay. So now what we can see, there is a loss in these six tubes, but there is an increase in these three tubes. Why? Because it is a dry calcium chloride. Dry calcium chloride or anhydrous calcium chloride has a capacity to absorb this wet vapors or solvent vapors and gets increase in the weight. So there is an increase in the weight. So now we can say what? Relative lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to the loss in the weight of the solvent and increase in the weight of calcium chloride tubes. So finally, I'm giving the formula, loss in the weight of solvent by increase in the weight of calcium chloride tubes is equals to the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, so this is completely about experimental method, and in order to calculate the relative lowering of vapor pressure, we need to calculate the loss in the weight of solvent and we need to calculate the increase in the weight of calcium chloride tubes. Okay, this is about experimental procedure or Ostwald's-Walker's experiment. Thank you so much for watching.